Hachette Audio presents Bamboozled by Jesus, How God Tricked Me Into the Life of My Dreams. Written and read by Yvonne Orji. Hey, boo. Yes, you. In case you didn't know, someone you've never even met is counting on you. They're waiting on your yes to living your dreams out loud so that they too can dream new dreams and believe in more than their circumstances dictate. No pressure, but pressure. Relax. The weight of the world is not on your shoulders. But it should stir you up to know that your life is bigger than the family that you were born into, or the school that you go to, or the job that you work at, or even the church you attend. Your sphere of influence is much larger, and God wants to highlight you to nations you don't even know about yet. You're going to be a change agent in your community. You're going to be the one to break generational curses in your family and alter the legacy of your lineage. God has called, equipped, and empowered you to be you exactly as you are. Think about it. The mother of the Savior was an unwed teenage girl. The second in command over Egypt was a former slave. The woman who saved her family from death and destruction was a prostitute. One of the greatest warriors in history was a forgotten shepherd boy. So why can't you do dope things? You can. That's the whole point. Even without the right connections, you're fine. Even though your funds are mad low, you'll still make it. Even when your hope is fading, pick it back up, boo. It gets darkest right before it gets the brightest. So don't give up. Scratch that. I won't let you give up. The world is waiting on your supply. So get to it, fam. All the best, Yvonne. Dedicated to all the immigrant parents who sacrifice so much so that their children can inherit the much more. You arrive at distant shores filled with uncertainty, resilience, and profound loss. Loss of community, of the life you imagined, and of home. I am the daughter of such immigrants. I am the answered prayers of ancestors. I am because of all they did and all they didn't. In the beginning, I was born holding my mom's IUD in my hand. True story. After three sons, my parents decided that their baby-making days were over. Clearly, God was like, nah. And 9 months later, I had to finally bust out of my mama's womb, clutching the very device meant to prevent my conception. That was my first taste of being bamboozled by Jesus. Now pause. I see the look of horror on the face of every listener either using or contemplating using an IUD. But relax. That was in the 80s in Nigeria. And I'm sure that there's been advances in medical technology by now. If not, maybe just name the baby God's will, because clearly it was. But ain't that just like God, though? He out here being the sovereign trickster in our lives, acting like the Ancient of Days Ashton Kutcher, running around town getting folks punked. Personally, I've fallen for the bamboozlement of Jesus several times. Like when I was a college freshman and I thought I was gonna live it up, I imagined my days consisting of partying, studying, and partying some more. You know, the basics. Little did I know how quickly those plans would be kiboshed and suddenly turned into attend a Bible study freshman year, commit my life to Jesus, and remain a virgin until I get married. What? Who agreed to... Bamboozled. Insert TEDx talk entitled, The Way to Sexy. You can find it on YouTube. Oh, but it didn't stop there. After graduation, I planned on going to medical school. You know, the pinnacle of success for every Nigerian child. Well, not according to Jesus, it wasn't. One day out of left field, I heard him tell me to perform stand-up comedy instead. Well, that's just ridiculous, I thought. I'd never done nor desired to do comedy, so I wouldn't even know the first thing about Bamboozled. Insert HBO comedy special, Mama I Made It. Streaming now on HBO Max. My life today is basically one big walking billboard of how God tricked me into living out my wildest dreams. I ain't mad at it, but along the way, I definitely had questions and a few choice words for Jesus that didn't start with, Dear Heavenly Anything. Thankfully, we made it. So, like I said, I ain't mad at it. Bamboozling people into a life that they never could have imagined for themselves is kind of like Jesus' M.O. All throughout the Bible, he suckered several unsuspecting targets into a life full of prestige and promise. And by suckered, I mean dragged through struggling pain before getting to the good stuff. But can you blame Jesus? He himself got bamboozled. God told him to come down to earth, perform a few dope miracles, because who doesn't like a little wine at a party? But then set him up for the okey-doke with the whole die on the cross for their sins thing. What? Heck, even Jesus' own mama Mary got bamboozled when an angel rolled up on her like, hey girl, go ahead and have this here baby. Now don't worry about the laws of biology or your boo thing Joseph. I got you covered. I don't know why the angels sound like Barry White, but okay. Apparently, nobody's safe in these here streets. Everybody can get it. Being bamboozled by Jesus is low-key the most frustratingly amazing thing that you'll ever experience. It ain't always sexy, but it is always worth it. But don't feel bad for wanting to tap out midway through. Even Jesus looked for an exit strategy. He straight up asked God, listen, if there be any other way, let this cup pass me by. In other words, fam, this ain't it. While you may want to chuck up the deuces, the only way out is to settle for less than God's best. And we're not about that life. Before we go any further, I do want to put out this disclaimer. You do not have to be a Bible scholar or devout evangelical to benefit from the pages in this book. I didn't go to anybody's seminary, nor am I an ordained anything. I'm just a young Black chick who entered into a beautiful relationship with a God that I've never met, but who chose to love me in unimaginable ways. So if you don't subscribe to the whole Christianity thing, that's cool. Get in where you fit in. Personally, my faith impacts my success and my life in general. So it's hard for me to separate the two, but I do promise to keep an open mind and an open heart. And all that I ask is that you do the same. If it makes you feel any better, for every Bible story I tell, I'll throw in a DMX, ayo, or a Cardi B reference, just for good measure. Because I'm well-rounded like that. You're welcome. Now to all my Sunday school saints, you might as well go ahead and give me grace right now as you fact-check my biblical knowledge with your Judge Not Lest You Be Judged First, New Living Word of God, First Baptist Church Special Edition translation. I'm letting you know up front that I'm probably going to do some things that irk you, like referring to the Bible as the Good Book, or DGB. You down with DGB? Yeah, you know me. Y'all, we can't afford the rights to that, so that's why I had to say it like that. I'll also irk you by interchangeably using Jesus and God, even though one is the Father and the other is the Son. But you know what? We all gonna make it. So everybody, calm down. And before you push the blasphemy button, I'm fully aware that some of the comparisons I make about your favorite Bible characters, like calling Abraham the first F-boy to ever exist, will elicit a sharp side eye. And I'm okay with that. This is how Jesus and I get down. We got our own thing going on, and he's the one who told me to become a comedian and write this book in the first place. So go ahead and take your complaints up with management, okay? Now, if you're one of the folks thinking, this book is ridiculous. Jesus is a loving savior. He would never bamboozle anybody. Just ask yourself this one thing. Were you alive in 2020? If so, then you already know that that entire year was one big bamboozled by Jesus petri dish. Everybody and their mama started off 2020 talking about how it would be a season of clear focus and 2020 vision. All the while, God sat back just giggling at us. We had no idea how glaringly clear things were about to become when 2.5 months into the year, the entire world got shut down thanks to a pandemic called COVID-19. Or COVID-19, depending on what clever spin your pastor put on it. The coronavirus and the subsequent global quarantine that followed forced us all to get back to the basics of humanity, hope, and hygiene. My good friend Debbie Brown described 2020 as a divine timeout. It was the best, worst kind of sit down and face the wall that nobody asked for, but kind of desperately needed. We definitely could have done without the millions of deaths worldwide, the unprecedented unemployment rates, and the blatant racial injustice experienced in the U.S. And I'm also pretty certain that a few parents would have opted out of being teacher, breadwinner, and after-school entertainment, all in one day and in one space. Whew, bless you guys. But 2020 did accomplish a few things. For starters, it exposed how fractured we were as a society and offered opportunities for healing. It taught us how the busyness of our lives distracted us from dealing with ourselves. And ultimately, it solved the mystery once and for all of just how much toilet paper is enough for one household. Why are you hogging all of it? Give me one. So yeah, nobody loves getting bamboozled or the 12 months of incessant Zoom calls, but we do appreciate what we gain on the flip side. I mean, at least I do. That's why I bothered to write this book in the first place. To help you endure so you can get to the other side. Trust me, if getting bamboozled by Jesus only stopped at the sucky parts, then I'd be the first one to tell you to exit stage left. But it doesn't, hence the subtitle, How God Tricked Me Into the Life of My Dreams. Spoiler alert, things worked out pretty well for me. And I'm confident that they'll work out great for you too. I'm not just saying that in a life coachery kind of way. That's cute and all, but that ain't me. While I aim to be kind and understanding throughout the book, I'm still an African immigrant woman at my core, and we have a limbo low tolerance for excuses and self-imposed limitations. So if you were expecting cucumber sandwiches with a side of encouragement, please do us both a favor and re-give this to your other best friend, because you got me twisted. I'm not the type of chick that'll give you advice like the friend you love to have. You know the one who doesn't challenge you, who pacifies you, and allows you to lie to yourself about your deficiencies until years later, you realize that you've been letting the most basic things keep you from living your best life. Yeah, that's whack. I'm more like the friend that you need to have. She's going to sound a lot like a no-nonsense Nigerian auntie who doesn't have time to waste and loves you too much to let you waste any of your own. Y'all, we got work to do, and you have purpose to fulfill. Yesterday is dead and gone like a Justin Timberlake song, and maximizing tomorrow depends on how well you execute today. So consider this your official warning. This is not a self-help book. Yes, I may be in the entertainment business, but I'm not here for your entertainment. Be honest. Y'all buy those self-help books pumped and ready to jumpstart a brand new you, and then what happens? 5 years later, those same books are doubling as coasters on your living room table. You never even made it past the first sentence of the first chapter. Nah, I ain't going out like that. Y'all gonna read this book, and not just read it, but apply it to activate the best you that's been lying dormant, waiting for a chance to bust out. So no, this is definitely not a self-help book. It's a get yours book. Now I've gotten mine, and I'm still getting more of it. So it would be selfish of me to not share whatever I've learned along the way to help you get yours too. The prophet Nate Dogg so poignantly stated that it ain't no fun if the homies can't get none. While he may have been referencing illicit sexual activity, that doesn't discount the wisdom of his words within the context of what I'm trying to say. Hopefully, by exposing you to key moments in my life, you can see for yourself that God isn't out to get you, but he is out to get some things to you. I'll probably hit a nerve or five and read your mail.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.